We're here to listen to the sounds of Buddy Koopman and his orchestra. For nearly two decades, the unparalleled sound of the big bands dominated American music. The entire country jumped and jived to the swinging tunes belted out by the brass-heavy ensembles which made music history in the nation's ballrooms, dance halls, and theaters. Those golden days with names like Dorsey, James, Krupa, Miller, Goodman, Brown, Anthony, Basie, and Rich dominated the hit parade. They're captured here tonight. Settle back and relive those years with the music of Buddy Koopman and his orchestra.
Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and once again, it's a pleasure to be here this evening. And a nice crowd this evening, and the weather's good for once in a while, one time. Anyway, this evening's event is being put out by the International Musicians Union Trust Fund and the Faribault Community Center. That's who's sponsoring this this event tonight. Without any further ado, I would like to call on our beautiful and talented and lovely effervescent Debbie Bigelow from Minneapolis. And she wants to do her favorite, which would be Sunday Kind of Love. So here's one that goes back to about 1948, I believe, called Sunday Kind of Love. Here we go.
Kind of love, the kind that lasts past Saturday night. I need to know it's more than love at first sight. I want a Sunday kind of love. I want a love that's on the square. Can't seem to find somebody who cares. I'm on a lonely road that leads me nowhere. I want a Sunday kind of love. I do my Sunday dreaming and all my Sunday scheming every minute. Every hour, every day, I'm open to discover a certain kind of lover who will show me the way. My arms need someone to enfold, to keep me warm when Mondays are cold. To have and to hold, I want a Sunday kind of love. I do. Thank you.
Come right down the front seat. Plenty of room. That was Phil Anderson on that fine trombone or trumpet solo. We're starting out again. Phil, stand up, would you? You know, this is about his 37th year with this organization, so he's turned from black to gray. And don't you think he's doing still a pretty good job? Our next one... Thank you. Our next song is one that I fell in love with many years ago. It was about 1947 I heard this gentleman play his trumpet. He played lead trumpet with the Miller organization for years and wanted to go on his own, so Glenn set him up in business, and I'd like to play this theme song that he made famous many years ago called Star Dreams. It was his theme song, Charlie Spivak.
Thank you.
shining through the trees. Don't that moon look lonesome, shining through the trees. Don't your arms look lonesome when your baby backs up to leave. I'm going up to the mountain, baby, but I can't take you. No. I'm going up to the mountain, but baby, I can't take you. Oh, no. There's nothing up there that a man like you can do. No way. Going back to that mountain to call that baby mine. I'm going back to that mountain to call that baby mine. Something tells me he's not coming back this time. Get this. He's got a face like a fish, shaped like a frog. But ooh, when he loves me, holla, oh, hot dog. I love that man better than I do myself. But I'm all alone on the shelf. Thank you.
Debbie Bigelow singing and Steve Bacall on the nice trombone. He also plays a little bass up there. Steve Bacall. Okay, our next one, I believe, is going to bring up Debbie again one more time. And on, by the way, that last solo over here was Gary Anderson, the son of Steve, or of Phil Anderson over here. Son, father, and son. Okay, we're going to do a little one Woody Herman made famous many years ago. He passed away a couple years ago, but this was one of his real classics called Early Autumn. We'd like to feature our good vocalist over here one more time. So here we have our Woody's rendition of Early Autumn.
the land and chills the breeze and touches with her hand the summer trees. Perhaps you'll understand what memories I own. There's a dance pavilion in the rain, all shuttered down a windy country lane, all russet brown, a frosted window pane shows me a town grown lonely. That thrill of ours that started so April-hearted seems made for just a boy and girl. I never dreamed, did you, any fall would come in view so early, early. So darling, if you care, please let me know, I'll meet you anywhere. I love you so, let's never have to share another early autumn.
She got so excited on that one, she started taking the sax course over here. So it worked out all right. That's a standard that's played more than any other song I know of. Every time you turn on the radio or something of the past, the nostalgic years, you hear In the Mood. The alto sax man is Dr. Hartley Clark. Would you stand up, Dr. Hartley Clark? And Gary Anderson over here on tenor again, and of course, Phil. Okay, we'd like to do another ballad at this time called Embraceable You, and bring our beautiful singer up here again one more time, and here's our rendition of Embraceable You.
And I don't even have to wait to come in this time.
thank you. Doesn't that bring back memories, though, when you hear these ballads like this, and you used to be younger, and you'd dance all night long, and you thought nothing of it? Remember those days? Beautiful. You'd turn on the radio, you had music coming, no matter where it was, from all over the country, you'd be hearing good live bands, because they played every night those years. Any ballroom or any main hotel had a big band. Anyway, at this time, I would like to take the time to recognize some of the musicians that played back in the early 40s. And I don't know if they're here tonight because I can't see out there. But Harry Granum, I don't know if he's here tonight. Is Harry here tonight? Good, beautiful. Well, Harry played piano and trumpet, and he did a lot of arranging. And I remember back in the early 40s, I asked him to arrange a few songs because at those days, we used to play for a lot of proms. And they had a certain theme for their proms, so we didn't have it in the library. And I'd ask Harry to arrange it. But he was one of the outstanding musicians around Faribault at that time in the 40s, 50s, and before. And if he could stand up just to recognize, I'd like to see Harry here, or wherever he is. Harry Granum, beautiful. Okay. He contributed an awful lot to the organization of music in the local area here. Another one was Johnny Miller. He played sax and he played a sweet sax. And he played with Harry. They had a fantastic combo. Is Johnny Miller here tonight? Good. Johnny, where are you? Stand up, Johnny. Good. Those two used to play at the Melody Mill, and they would play a lot of places, and I'd come in with our big orchestra, and we'd blow the Melody Mill halfway across the country because it was a tin roof. So it was pretty hard to, you know, to hear it. When they had a nice, smooth combo, we'd have a big organization. Another one is Herbie Selner. Is Herbie here tonight? Herbie Selner played a lot of trombone. Herbie, would you stand up? He played good. I'm recognizing these musicians because they have not had any, you know, welcome people to tell them that they've done great jobs over the years. And Herbie used to play a lot of progressive trombone, a lot of jazz trombone. Another one was Oscar Tisberg. Is Mr. Tisberg, Oscar Tisberg here? Okay, Oscar Tisberg. Good. He used to play in our organization back in the 50s, and he used to sit next to a fellow that used to play third sax, I believe, with Jimmy Dorsey. So he played with good company. But I got to say a little thing about Oscar Tisberg. He was my band director in high school, and he was my mentor, and I tried to cultivate my intellect. And now he played with me after that, and he's played with me many times. But he is a real fine musician. He plays clarinet and tenor sax. Another one was Merton Hoover. He played tuba. Is Merton Hoover here? Merton Hoover. Okay, Mert, good. Beautiful. Beautiful. He played an awful lot of old time, and he played an all around. I don't know if he played with the Six Fats or not. I don't know, but you played with an awful lot of organizations. Another one was Ray Murphy. I don't know if he's here tonight. He played bass viol. And another one was Milo Larson. He played many years ago with drums. Milo, are you here tonight? Milo, stand up, okay? Okay. We'd like to go back a few years when Dorsey was at his pinnacle, and he came out with a song that was really super. You can turn the headlights off now. And we'd like to do his rendition of On the Sunny Side of the Street. Remember this song? Thank you. I didn't mention, but Dr. Hartley Clark used to play with the Carlton band at St. Olaf, and that was during the 40s when he was going to school. He played in the big Carlton band over there. And of course, Phil played at that time over there with the Carlton boys. So they've played a few years. And I know Bob Sandin has played with every major organization around the country in southern Minnesota from one end to the other, and he's also an excellent singer. But at this time now, we'd like to play one that Miller really made famous during the years in the service, and it was called Danny Boy, and he had a rendition that was fantastic over in London, otherwise known as Londonderry Air, and here's his arrangement.
Thank you.
You know, in the big band, there's always a small combo within the big band. And we've got Phil Anderson over here on the trumpet that's going to play a little bit. Gary Anderson, his son over here. Rick Wind on the drum over here. And Doug Mano on piano. And Steve Pakal on the bass. We're going to play a little Limehouse Blues. Okay, fellas? Okay. Okay. You're not going to play it, or are you going to play it? We always do this on jobs, you know. We play with something, we don't know if we're really playing or not. Okay? Let's try it. That's when you call talent. They didn't know. I said, let's blow it, and they're going to blow it. So it's pretty nice. Okay, we're going back a few more years. Les Brown put one of these out, and I remember during the service, the fellows would say, oh, man, listen to that Doris Day when she sings this song. It's fantastic. So here's Debbie going to do the same thing, a little called Sentimental Journey.
I got my bag
I got my reservation. I spent each dime I could afford. Like a child in wild anticipation, I long to hear that all aboard. Seven, that's the time we leave at seven. I'll be waiting up for heaven, counting every mile of a railroad track that takes me back. I never thought my heart could be so yearning. Why did I decide to roam? I'm gonna take a sentimental journey, sentimental journey home. Thank you.
I might make this announcement. That was for my sister, the last one there, Sentimental Journey. She just got out of the hospital, so I played that for her. But now we'd like to do one again for Johnny Miller called Shantytown. Johnny Miller. Okay, Johnny, remember when what's his name put that out? Johnny Long put that out. It was fantastic. So here's his rendition. Johnny. Thank you. Phil plays still a nice horn. Our trombone player is a professor over at Carleton College, excuse me, Rod Rodman. Would you please stand up, Rod? Thank you. Okay, now I believe we're on to one that you probably haven't heard us play for many, many, many years. It's one that Duke Ellington made famous, but who had a real good arrangement in the later years was Les Brown. Let's see if you can pick this one out. Here's one Benny Goodman made famous many years ago, and then we're going to take a little 15-minute intermission, and we'll be back. And it was called Don't Be That Way. But before we do, I'd like to introduce the brass section here, just the bones here. I got to get my paper out because we change sometimes. Ron Rodman from Carleton College is a professor of music over there. Ron, would you please stand up? Todd Harvey is from Northfield, and he's from the Fireside Apple Orchard over there, and he's a manager over there. Todd Harvey. Then we have Dave Bodie, who it's my pleasure to introduce to this young man. He is in ninth grade, and he's playing second trombone with us. Would you please stand up, Dave? That's marvelous. Ninth grade, playing in an organization like this. He's playing with some good musicians. Anyway, then we have an agronomist who is a farmer, Brian Connie, from over in Owatonna. Brian, would you stand up? And Warner Halverson is from Owatonna, and he teaches. He's a teacher over in Medford, and he's a social studies teacher, and he also directs the band over there. Warner, would you please stand up? Roger Belke, I know everyone knows him. Rog, stand up. Rog Belke has been he's a retired teacher, music teacher, and he has probably had an awful lot of the students. He's like Mr. Teisberger. He knows everyone in town. Okay, the next man we have over here is Brent Holgerson, and he's from Northrop King over in Northfield. Okay, and last but least is a fellow's played with me, and I can't say enough about him. He's done everything. He's an apiarist. He's a honey man. He always says a little honey in the morning, a little honey at night. It takes care of everything. But boy, have I got arthritis. I tell you. Phil, stand up. Okay. And I'll do one more, and then we'll get the saxes later. But anyway, we got Rick Wind over on the drums. He's a teacher at the senior high school. Rick, would you please stand up? Okay. Glenn Miller used to play that an awful lot, and when he was playing at the Glen Island Casino in Rochelle, New York, it was phenomenal. Just absolutely phenomenal. Well, at this time, we'd like to bring our bass player down to do a little Tommy Dorsey's I'm Getting Sentimental Over You, and that came out in about 1934 when TD used to blow that. So we're going to take a little... Are you ready, Steve Bacall? I'm Getting Sentimental Over You. Call. Okay. Here's one that needs no introduction. I'd like to play this for Buck Birkensmeyer because he really swings on this one. I think I do every time, but Buck, this is for you if you're here tonight. We're going to do a little of that Woody stuff. Come on down. Here we go. One, two, three, four. Okay. Is Debbie around? We're going to play a little Moon Glow. And we feature our singer, Debbie Bigelow.
you.
Time is getting a little short because we have to be out of here according to the regulations. So we're going to close with this one song, and hopefully you'll remember this one very closely. Thank you. Wonderful. Thank you so much. Okay, one more. Okay. 250. We're going to bring Debbie out and put one up temple, so when you leave, you'll remember this one. Okay?
Hey, you've been a great audience. Give yourselves a big hand. All right. Thank you. Thanks for coming out this evening. All of me, that's the next one. And I've got a lot coming extra large here. All of me, why not take all of me? You see, I'm no good without you. Take my lips, I want to lose them. Take my arms, I'll never use them. Your goodbye left me with eyes that cry. Oh, how could I go on, dear, without you? You took the part that once was my heart. So why'd I take it? Take all of me. Thank you. Whoa. Thank you. All right, Gary. Take all of me. Woo, why not?
Hassan, thank you so much for turning out this evening. We appreciate the audience. A lot of these songs we haven't played for a long time. It was the first time tonight on some of them. So thanks again. Come again and have a safe journey home, and happy Thanksgiving.